Day two of the World Championships focuses on the 59-kilogram division for men and the 50 for women, which was held this afternoon. Eight of the 10 Barcelona Olympic champions competing here in Melbourne in what's been billed as the champs of the century. And tomorrow in our live telecast, we feature Naim Suleymanoglu from Turkey, but dual Olympic silver medalist Robert Kabas. Robert, what are you expecting in this 59K division?
Well, since the Seoul Olympics, the Koreans have come on in leaps and bounds, and I'm expecting the current Olympic and world champion Chung Byung-kwan from Korea to successfully defend his title. But also he has to put up with Nikolai Peshalov, who has a rare victory over Suleymanoglu at last year's Europeans. And thereabouts in the finish will be the lesser-known Suleymanoglu Hafiz, who is also a former world champion.
Now, Sevdalen Marinov, the Australian member of the Wild Bunch, performed in the B division.
He performed reasonably well. He's been suffering from a knee injury lately, which has affected his training, and of course his leg strength would be down on what he would expect. Here we see him attempting 120 kilograms in the snatch. He's a former world record holder on this lift in the lower weight category, 52 kilograms.
He has been troubled by that knee injury which was sustained at the AIS in camp in Canberra prior to this meet.
As you can see, it's a very low position in his snatch, and this would aggravate any pain he's feeling in his knee as he sets himself. And look at that position, it's tremendous. I mean, his backside's almost on the platform.
Yes, the former world and Olympic champion certainly gets very low, and he'll be looking for big things at the Commonwealth Games next year, I guess.
Yes, certainly. He would have to start favourite for those, and along with the other members of the Wild Bunch.
Well, let's have a look at the start list then in the A division. And South Korea, certainly the favourite here for the gold.
Yes, certainly. But as I said, Peshalov almost equal favouritism.
First lifter is Marcus Stephen from Nauru, who really has honed his weightlifting skills here at the Hawthorne Club in Melbourne. He boarded at St. Bede's Mentone.
Can we call the referees into their positions, please?
He's currently studying for a major in accounting at the RMIT. And he's one of the most promising lifters raised in this country. Robert Kabas.
Yes, that's very true. He's a very strong young man, and this division probably suits him. He used to compete in the 60 kilogram class, but has no trouble coming down that extra kilo to 59. Very strong and very steady under pressure as well.
150 kilograms. First attempt, Marcus Stephen Nauru.
So this is really a hometown audience for Marcus Stephen. The snatch is not his best lift. He does have a couple of technical faults, but he's been working hard on those in the camp at the AIS in Canberra. The bar at 115 kilograms for his first attempt.
Basically, he's very strong physically, but doesn't get probably the most out of himself in the in achieving a low squat position in his snatching.
And that's the start he wanted. Admittedly, only 115 kilograms, but he's on the board, and he's a very strong performer in the clean and jerk.
There's absolutely nothing wrong with that snatch. Very good, very solid. It's often very hard for, especially for the first lifter out on the platform. Here is again plenty of height, very determined.
Second attempt at 120 for Mujahit Yaksi of Turkey. He failed at his first at this weight.
Physically, he's quite slender for a weightlifter, which normally would tend to indicate that the clean and jerk won't be a very strong lift for him. So it's important for him to get this lift and then go on and possibly get another successful attempt.
Buzzer for 30 seconds remaining. So it was a nervous first lift, but the butterflies have gone after that one. successful at 120 with his second attempt.
Same weight, 120.
I think you were right there. He hit the nail on the head. He just needed to settle down his nerves and just get on with the job of snatching the weight. It's obviously well within his capabilities, and he just seemed to wake up a little bit there. Here it is again. Plenty of height. It's quite nice technique.
Well, a very big thrill for this young man from Nauru. The national sport over there, by the way, is Australian football. Although Marcus Stephen played rugby union as a hooker before taking up weightlifting. He'll be aiming to stay over the bar here, pull it straight instead of jumping back as he did with his second attempt.
Plenty of concentration. He is normally very steady under pressure, and I wouldn't be surprised if he got this.
Third and final attempt. The crowd urging him silently. He didn't jump back that time. Magnificent performance by Marcus Stephen. Luke Borogini applauds the young man. That really was a fighting effort, Robert Cabas.
Yeah, he didn't let me down. I thought he might get it, and he makes me sound like more of an expert by doing it.
From Bulgaria. The lifter to follow.
Well, when you consider that Sevdalin Marinov competed in the B division, a former Olympic champion, gives you an idea of the enormity of this performance by a man from such a tiny country as Nauru. So Tung Nin Cheng of China, having succeeded at 125, now trying to emulate his compatriot Kishan Lin, who's already cleared that weight. 127.5, second attempt, Nin Cheng of China.
Now, he cleared 125 kilos fairly easily with his first attempt, and I'm surprised that he's only taking the limited or the minimum increase of 2.5 kilograms at this stage. I would have thought he would have gone to 130.
Yes, well, that tends to indicate that. 127.5, again, very comfortable.
This is a fairly new rule where you can jump only 2.5 kilograms in weightlifting. It used to be a minimum of 5, and still a lot of lifters tend not to take advantage of it.
Successful lifter to follow will be Chun Yung Kwan, Korea. Dan Sonsu, Chun Yung Kwan, Korea.
Clock starts here for Yorgos Solidis of Greece. Important lift, failing at his first attempt of 127.5. Second lift now in the snatch competition. Doesn't want to have himself in the situation where he needs the third attempt at this weight and the threat of bombing out. He's lost it over the back again.
Well, he's now in that unfortunate position that you did mention. He needs that third attempt just to stay in the competition. Closer than his first attempt, but probably overcompensated. He missed the first one front, and this one goes the other way backwards.
Gillilis must succeed with his weight.
Of course, what happens when a lifter misses twice on their starting weight, not only does it affect them, it affects the lifter who's waiting to take the next weight, such as this man, Chun Byung Kwan.
Well, so, moment of truth here, Robert.
Yes, he certainly had plenty of encouragement there. He seemed to have about 16 different Greek officials around him, and let's hope he had a chance to concentrate and gather his thoughts.
He did it this time. Well done, Yorgos. Well, that's what World Championship weightlifting is all about.
Certainly. I mean, you couldn't get any more pressure than that. And obviously, one of the many Greek officials and coaches around him must have said the right thing to him, because that lift certainly hit the spot.
So here's the man who really has to produce it here. Hafiz Süleymanoğlu of Turkey. Failing at his first attempt of 130. He really has to shake the monkey here. Plenty of time on the clock. 35 seconds to go. Oh, yes.
Now, that's a definite look of relief on his face.
Well, there's a very big Turkish contingent here, and they're jumping up and down after that performance.
Third attempt of Tang Ningxing, China.
Well, now he's in the competition, and hopefully he can get on with it. Unusual elbow position there, and he has dislocated an elbow in the past.
Will be Ikehata, Japan.
So a final lift here.
Ningxing, China.
Ningxing of China is being called up at 130. He's cleared 125, 127 and a half, and now 130. So he's looking for a third straight successful lift. This will certainly keep him in the medal hunt.
Yeah, he's looked pretty steady right through. He's had a nice solid series. But I still have to think that he possibly should have taken this on his second attempt and maybe gone for more, or if he missed it, he could have had a second go at it. There it is once again.
Yes, he looked to have a few more kilograms in him, but he'll have to be satisfied with 130, and the Chinese aren't complaining.
Well, possibly it was close to his personal best or a personal best, but with weightlifting, you only get three attempts and you have to use them up as wisely as possible. Neither start too high, and but then again, give yourself a chance to get your best.
Ikehata from Japan. Successful with his first lift of 125. Missed his second at 130. Can he do it here with his third?
This is one of the hardest things about a world championship compared to a lower level or a national championship. You get so many lifters handling weights close to each other that there can be a long wait between attempts, and then the lifter has to decide whether to start warming up again, take another heavy lift, or just walk around. And concentration, of course, is always a big problem, as well as fitness. Good fighting lift.
Good lift.
The crowd really applauding that effort by Hiroshi Ikehata. He looked to be in a little bit of bother early on.
Yep, he almost repeated his miss on the last attempt, but this time he does control it and just won't let it go back.
Now, it's the Chinese lifter, Qishan Lin. Second attempt, 132.5. This will be the biggest lift so far.
Yes, this is for the outright lead, 132.5 kilos. And that's quite a comfortable lift for him.
Qishan Lin throwing out the challenge to some of the more fancied rivals. He's on the board at 132.5 and in front position.
Yep, that's an excellent lift. We've got the starting list here for the jerks, which we'll see much later, and he's not as strong in the second lift.
Nikolai Pashalov of Bulgaria coming up for his first attempt here. He's the only lifter we haven't seen so far. 1:35. The clock has started, so he has 1 minute before he must raise the barbell.
This is the man we expect to fight it out with, Chun Byung-kwan, for the gold medal. They haven't met very often before because the Korean has moved up from what used to be the 56 kilogram class, whereas Pesholov has reduced from the 60 kilogram class he used to compete in.
First appearance of Nikolai Pesholov from Bulgaria at 1:35.
Strong lift. Even though he's young, he's an experienced weightlifter for Bulgaria, and as we mentioned, he has one of those rare victories over Naim Süleymanoğlu. So he's certainly someone to fear in competition.
As Chun Byung-kwan has a lighter body weight, 0.01.
So Byung-kwan Chun from Korea, 1:35 now. But he is just 10 grams lighter than Nikolai, which, of course, with a lower body weight, gives him the advantage and the lead if he is successful here. Buzzer for 30 seconds.
Taking his time setting with his first attempt. He had just 3 seconds left on the clock.
Well, he still has one more opportunity to get 1:35, but a big advantage here for Pesholov, the Bulgarian.
It wasn't that far off, very flexible. So he hits a very low bottom position, and his shoulders are very flexible, and he just couldn't hang on to it.
He cleared 1:30 after missing at his first attempt. And this will really keep him in the major medal hunt.
Former world champion, so he's been in this situation many times before. Originally a product of the Soviet weightlifting system, so a tough competitor.
Oh yes, he's done it again. Turkey in the limelights. 1:35. Now he has a slightly heavier body weight, so he moves into second place.
There it is again. Nice technique, fights it out all the way. It's good to see a lifter with a bit of animation as well. Makes a bit of noise.
Second attempt, the bar at 1:37 and a half, which is the world record held by Nikolai.
Now, with Chun Byung-kwan missing on those two attempts, it has taken a certain amount of pressure off Pesholov. He can afford to be conservative and just take a 2.5 kilo jump and not risk a jump to 140, establish a good lead, and still have a third attempt to increase that lead. So we can see how vital that last attempt miss was for the Korean.
Bulgarian was very strong at 1:35. He's gone up 2.5 here. Lift we've seen so far, and he's out to a lead of 5 kilograms with one lift remaining.
That is a tremendous lift.
Below 140 kilograms.
As you said, he has a lead of 5 kilograms, but more importantly of 7 kilograms over his main rival, Chun Byung-kwan.
Pashilov of Bulgaria has the chance here to open up a gap over arch rival Byung Kwan Chun of Korea. A gap of 10 kilograms. If he can take this lift at 140 and also break his existing world record. Third and final attempt.
He looks pretty confident. He was chatting quite relaxed with his coaches backstage. Apart from a little problem he had with his finger where he's obviously torn it or has torn a callus and he's had that taped up. And he looks ready for it now. Just adjusting his grip. Quick check of the time. Shows he's only got 5 seconds left. And just loses it behind. Just likes a wry smile of disappointment there.
So, still a magnificent performance of 137.5 by Nikolai Pushilov. And that also gives Byung Kwan Chun still a fighting chance because he has a slightly lower body weight. Nikolai Pushilov of Bulgaria has this 2.5 kilogram lead over Hafiz. Kishan Lin of China in third place. And the Korean still with a big job in front after clearing just 130, Byung Kwan Chun. Marcus has just over 1 minute remaining on the clock. Positive thoughts from his coach, Paul Coffer. And he'll be looking for some support here from the crowd.
Marcus Steve, now
seconds remaining. 157.5, second attempt.
Well, let's hope he can put this away now and then look for bigger things on his third attempt. He's very strong in this lift, in the clean and jerk. And the way things are, if he has a good day out, he might even be in contention for a medal. But first priority is to concentrate on this lift and get himself on the board.
Good rhythm and a stronger clean this time. Oh, he pulls it.
Come on, push.
Hold it there. Well, that was unbelievable. A very brave lift there by the young man from the room. He gets two white lights. That's all he needs.
And that's the sort of thing you expect from him. Very, very, very determined. And if it's anywhere near there, he's going to hold on to it. Very strong clean. And in the jerk, it's just a little bit sideways, and really many men would have lost that lift. But he just fights on. Terrific.
World records are kept for juniors, juniors being under Yorgos 20 years of age.
Zalilis from Greece.
Suleymanoglu, get ready, you're next.
Appearing for the first time with the barbell at 160.
Well, this is quite a surprise that he's starting this high. Originally, he was listed to start on 150. This is 160. So either he's warmed up very well or he's taking a bit of a gamble.
Well, the gamble has paid off. And the Greek fans are jumping up and down.
Obviously, he's warmed up very well. And we've got a bit of a turn up here, really. We're right towards the end of the clean and jerks. And we still have a lifter from Greece. And we still have Marcus Stephen from Nauru. So the power is being evenly distributed in the world of weightlifting.
Follow
will be plenty of chalk on the hands and palms for Hafiz Suleyman Oglu. He missed with his first attempt at 160. He was in second place after the snatch. This is a critical attempt for him.
Well, he's really got himself in a bad spot again. He always seems to struggle at world championships. As we said, won the world title in 89, and since then has bombed or injured at just about every world championship.
Now he just needs to take his time a bit more here. And again. He does it as he performed in the snatch, much to the delight of the Turkish fans, after missing with his first attempt. And I think you hit it on the head, Robert, with his first attempt. He was right on his throat. He tried to juggle the bar off his throat. He started to black out, but this time he had the barbell in a much more comfortable situation.
That's right. He was much more comfortable in the jerk, and he drove it a lot higher and was able to secure.
Tung Nin Sheng really has a big leeway to make up here. 10 kilograms behind our leader, Nikolai Pushilov. Pushilov currently with a total of 300, which is a world record total. Second attempt, 162.5 for Ninsheng.
I think with the lead that Pushilov has in the snatch, some of these guys may be conceding the overall title to him, but they're certainly trying for the gold in the clean and jerk.
He's got to be steady now, he is.
Good lift.
Well, you can hear Luke Borogini, the Australian head coach, telling Marcus Stephen, this is it. It's been a very commendable performance. He's a long way behind the leader, but 162.5 would be above the old record, world record standard. Third attempt.
Well, this is a great moment for Marcus. He's vying to take the lead in the clean and jerk. He'll be in the gold medal position after this lift, with only a number of lifts after him. And it's a strong clean, probably better than his 157, so he's a real chance here. Push!
His right knee just touching the ground. Paul Cotter's face says it all. Yorgos Zoulilos of Greece. Second attempt at 165.
The lift and the follow will be...
Looked very strong with his first at 160, but he's still a long way off the pace. Remember, our leader, Nikolai Pushilov, has a total of 300 after his first clean and jerk, so he's 12 and a half kilos behind. 165.
And the thing that's on his mind at the moment is perhaps this could get him a gold medal in the clean and jerk.
Fantastic lift by the Greek. Beating the world standard.
Well, this man's turned out to be the surprise packet of the whole division. He got off to a pretty rugged start. He missed his first two snatches, got his third, but now he's really come into form in the clean and jerk, and this lift really is no harder than his first. And he's going to be looking at catching Suleyman Oglu if he can.
Now with his final attempt at 165, he cannot win the gold medal.
Yes, Byung Kwan Chun is conceded the gold medal, as we thought he had to Pushilov. And really, he must get this way to salvage some sort of pride or whatever from this competition, because he's found the going pretty tough in this heavier weight class. He used to be in the 56 kilo class, and he's found the going really tough here.
He needs this lift to ensure a minor medal, and It was just too much for him.
Just a little bit too heavy, whether he was blacking out or whether he felt the weight was just too heavy, it just wasn't there tonight.
He's cleared 162.5, he's now up to 167.5.
He's been looking pretty relaxed and confident right through, almost cocky, really, so we'll see how he goes with this one. He just seemed to squeeze himself under that bar. He didn't have quite enough height on it, whether he's hurt his back a little bit.
167.5 now for Yorgos Zolilis from Greece. 2.5 kilograms behind second place at the moment.
It's a strong point. No. Well, I'm surprised he didn't get up with that, because with his first and second attempts, he didn't give an indication that there was anything wrong with his leg strength. Just that too deep in the squat position.
167.5, the gold medal is his, but he needs to be successful here to take the gold medal in the clean and jerk away from the Greek.
I'm sure he'd love to go for a clean sweep of all medals, and also, of course, the world record in the jerk and the total that go with it. In there with a chance. Definitely not impossible for him to get it. If anything, it's just human nature that in the back of his mind, subconsciously, he knows he's already won, so there must be some level of relaxation there. It's a different thing if he's going out there and he knows that he needs this lift, that it's a must, he's got to get it to win. Once again, just squeezes on it.
This is for a new world record.
And he's hanging on this time.
He's looking at those judges. And he is over the moon. The Bulgarian smashing the clean and jerk world record, the total world record, and taking a clean sweep of the gold medals to boot.
Well, if you couldn't get any happier scenes than those in the back room at the moment.
That completes the attempt.
There he goes. Almost really a copy of his second attempt in the clean. He's a little bit of trouble getting out of the top. Sets for the jerk, drives it up, fights it through, and he must get his feet in line. It doesn't matter if he's not straight, his feet must be in line. And as soon as it's steady, he's got it.
Nikolai Pushilov. We saw there he did have a bit of a problem with a callus on one of his fingers. And despite that minor ailment, he's managed to shatter the world records here with that last attempt in the clean and jerk. The overall standings in the men's 59 kilograms, Nikolai Peshilov of Bulgaria reigning supreme, and the big surprise, Byung Kwon Chun of Korea finishing back in fourth place, the world and Olympic champion. And a very creditable performance by Marcus Stephen, who's done all his training in Australia, the man from Nauru, back in eighth.
Representing Bulgaria, Nikolai Peshilov.
Nikolai Peshilov picking up where his countryman Ivan Ivanov left off on the opening night. A clean sweep of the gold medals for Nikolai, and Bulgaria affirming its elite status in international weightlifting.
And now we move on to the women, and last night in the 46 kilogram division, Chinese Taipei dominated, finishing 1-2, and Nun Mei Chu taking the gold. But now the women have moved up to 50 kilograms, with Chinese dominance certainly anticipated. And it worked out that way. But joining me is Sally Penson, the Australian champion, Amanda Inman competing in the B division.
Yes, Amanda did very well. She's only young. She's got a lot of years ahead of her, and this was really an experience for her. She did a 62.5 clean and jerk, which approaches her best. She needs a lot more leg strength, but that's going to come with time. We see her here setting herself on the bar. She has a little bit of difficulty pushing up out of that. There's a bit of strain on the face before she dips. A little bit wonky there, but she does manage to hold the weight.
So she's one of Australia's lifters of the future. But we're going back to the past. We're going to look at the 50-kilogram division and records galore here. But interesting that Guan Hong moved up from 46 Ks for China.
Yes, apparently Guan Hong couldn't make weight. She didn't have enough time to lose the last couple of grams to get into the 46-kilo division. So she had to be satisfied to lift with the heavier girls.
Well, the main contenders here will be Liu Xiuhua from China and also Guan Hong, Li Chuan Chao, Myung Shik Choi. It's going to be a very interesting contest in the A group. Now, the pressure here on Shumova, because the clock shows only 19 seconds to go, and she may not even make the lift in time here.
I think she will make it.
But it certainly wasn't the preparation she needed for that third and final attempt.
No,
a mix-up backstage.
Yes, that was a shame because I feel that weight was in her capability. You can see the clock in the background counting down. And she with 6 seconds to go, she moved the bar. And she was probably feeling a bit pressured there.
So now Myung Shik Choi, the tiny Korean, who weighed in at 49.31 kilograms, attempting 75. She failed at that weight with her previous attempt. This is a world record lift and would put her in first place.
Would also put the pressure on her teammate, who will follow her for her third attempt at the same weight. A lot of concentration. That's a good lift.
And that's a world record. Myung Shik Choi from Korea. Good super effort, 75 kilograms, the previous world standard, 72.5.
The same weight, 75 kilos.
Her teammate, Myung Shik Choi, weighs 49.31. Chiu Chun weighs 49.3. Chiu Chun Kuo beat her teammate because she's the lighter lifter. If she gets this weight.
She's attempting that new world mark of 75 kilograms.
That's an easy lift.
And she proved that her second attempt was no form guide at all. So a fine lift there by Chiu Chun Kuo, 75 kilograms, and that will be her total for the snatch.
77.5, this is for the first attempt of Liu Xiuhua from China.
So the first attempt now to follow this excellent effort.
Liu Xiuhua has requested 77.5 kilos.
This is her first time on the platform. This will be a world record lift at her first attempt. She's the favorite for the gold medal, Liu Xiuhua from China.
She is last year's 48 kilo world champion.
No fuss there, and that is a world record, 77.5.
World lift and a world record with a first attempt.
Yes,
first attempt.
Same weight, 77.5 kilos. First attempt for Guan.
This is a routine lift from
China.
Liu Siyua.
A lift at a
fall. She's toying with these weights. You can see that her leg strength and muscle definition all indicate that this woman can lift a lot more weight. These Chinese women are full-time athletes. They train up to 5 hours a day.
She's got plenty of time on the clock. She has 2 minutes after failing at a weight. And when she follows herself, so her second attempt now, it's 77.5. Very tense moment here for the Chinese team.
I notice she's taken her shorts off. Maybe they were annoying her in the previous lift. Yes.
Great confidence from Guan Hong. The lightest lifter here in this division. 77.5 equals the world record of her Chinese teammate Liu Xiuhua.
Yes, and the technique that Guan Hong is displaying is picture perfect. The bar is pulled close to her body. She gets under the bar very quickly and she stands up with great amount of strength.
Yes, a magnificent building. The Royal Exhibition, now 113 years old. It was the venue for the opening of the first Parliament of the Commonwealth in 1901. It's also served as a hospital, a wartime Air Force base, and it was the home of the Victorian Parliament for 26 years. A big moment for Guan Hong, 80 kilograms. Her third and final attempt, this for a new world record. Can she go up?
Oh, no.
Well, the urging came from the Chinese camp, but she just couldn't hold it steady overhead.
With 80 kilos.
She still placed the second in this heavier weight class for her. The question I ask is, why did she come up to this weight class? She's an obvious gold medalist in the 46 kilo class.
Liu Xiuhua has decided that 77.5 kilos and the world record is enough. She will not take her second.
So there is to be no third or second or third attempt from Liu Xiuhua.
Now, have you seen that before, Sally, in a world championship? First lift, 77.5, a world record. Places her and a teammate in the front positions, but Guan Hong, with the lower body weight, has taken the gold medal, when quite obviously Liu Xiuhua could have possibly beaten that world mark.
She will set a new
so
record.
So now it's Miang Shik Choi, a lifter from Korea, who was fourth Chinese after the snatch. She's attempting 92.5 here. And this will be a new world record. A magnificent start by the Korean, Myung Shik Choi.
Good lift from Myung Shik Choi.
She's established a new world mark in the clean and jerk with that lift of 92.5 kilograms.
First attempt.
Myung Shik Choi is very short. It's an advantage in weightlifting. With those little short arms, she doesn't have to push the bar very far above her head.
She will equal.
The bar sits not even a foot above her head. If we compare her to the Bulgarian Nelly Samova with long arms, Nelly has to work harder. She has to move the bar over a longer range.
That's also given her a world record total as well. But I'd say she's only holding it on sufferance.
You can see that there's a lot of activity in the warm-up room with coaches looking at the warm-up scoreboard. And this is the long walkway. Now, Guan Hong has only 38 seconds now. She's been caught a bit short. So this will be a little bit rushed, this attempt.
95 kilograms on the board, first attempt. She has 25 seconds to go, so she doesn't have to rush things now. This will establish a world record.
The buzzer that you hear is a 30-second warning buzzer.
And she's done it very comfortably. Guan Hong of China establishes a new world mark of 95 kilograms. She won the gold medal in the snatch, and she jumps into first place overall.
It's a very comfortable lift. The bar is pulled close to her body. Enormous leg strength to come up out of the clean. The bar above her head, and as you can see, Guan Hong has stepped back. And that's what should happen.
So now an important final lift for Nelly Simova of Bulgaria, who's been very consistent. She succeeded with 85 and then 90. And now she's attempting 95, which would be a PB for her and would equal the world record.
It's certainly within her capabilities today. She's lifting very well.
This will be a fantastic effort if she can do it.
Yes, yes, she chases it. That's a good lift.
A marvellous effort there by the Bulgarian Nelly Simova. 95 kilograms. A PB, she can't believe it.
Second attempt. Myung-shik Choi from Korea. The lift to follow will be Ko Chu Chuen from Chinese Taipei.
This lift puts Simova into the total lead and certainly puts her in contention for a minor medal in the clean and jerk category.
167.5 for Simova, her total. And that's a world record total, passing the old world record of 160. But remember that Guan Hong has established a new world record total with her first up clean and jerk of 95 following her snatch of 77.5.
Myung-shik Choi from Korea, a little short lass. 95 kilos on the bar.
Well, there's a problem with the buzzer. It didn't affect her, though. Perhaps it enhanced her concentration and focus because she, too, can equal that world record mark of 95.
Yes, you can hear the 30-second warning buzzer has jammed.
Second attempt for Ko Chu Chuen from Chinese Taipei. And the lifter to follow will be Kunjarani, India.
Yeah, a little bit of give in the lower back there. It wasn't as comfortable as it could be.
So she's got some bonus seconds and she still has a minute 40 to go. So there's no need to hurry it here for Chiu Chun Huo. The clock was adjusted, but as you can see, plenty of time remaining. So she was in third place after the snatch. And 95 kilograms. She failed at this weight with her second attempt. This is her last.
Yes, that's a good lift. Three white lights for that one.
Terrific performance.
Good lift forward.
Chiu Chun Kuo.
And
Taipei, remember, were in the money in the 46 kilogram division through Nan Mei and also Xiu Fen last night.
New record once more for Zhu.
So Guan Hong now with the bar at 100 kilograms. Third and last attempt, and the current leader. But we still haven't seen Liu Xiuhua, a Chinese teammate. What's she going to do? This will be another world record lift, bettering her previous mark by 2.5 kilograms. Oh. Mighty effort by Guan Hong, absolutely staggering. She was a mile ahead of everyone in the 46 kilogram division, but decided to go up to the 50 kgs. And she has finished with a total of 177.5. That was a world record, and so is her total.
The weight has been called 102.5 for the first attempt for the last lifter here from China.
If she succeeds, Liu Xiuhua, she will set new world records for juniors and total.
Well, this is quite astonishing. We may even only see one lift here from Liu Xiuhua, because if successful, she would be in the gold medal position for the clean and jerk and the overall total, and wouldn't have to keep going. That would mean she'd take the gold medal with one lift in the snatch and one lift in the clean and jerk. So the world record and the gold medal at stake here for Liu Xiuhua of China. Oh, she looks so strong. Well, that is a sensational performance by Liu Xiuhua. That's the gold medal. That's the world record. You can't do any better than that.
Liu Xiuhua with 102.5 kilos. Load 105 kilos.
So she's going to take more attempts, but this is so easy. She is so much better than all these other girls in this division.
So the weight being adjusted, and it's gone up to 110 for her second attempt. So she's going up 7.5 kilograms. That's how confident she is.
And she's also still got the good part of 2 minutes left. So these athletes are very fit for weightlifting. Still a very easy clean.
She's done it easily in training, and she's done it in the World Championship, smashing her world record by a staggering 7.5 kilograms. She streaks ahead of her rivals.
Liu Xiuhua has decided that's quite enough work for
her. Yes, that's enough. She's only taking two attempts. 110 is enough for her. She's capable of doing 115, though, I believe, at least. What a beautiful lifter to watch. They're so composed, these Chinese girls, and technically so perfect. Everything is in line. The back is straight. The bar is kept close to the body and always straight above the head.
The Chinese gold medalist has obliterated the other countries. The third place getter, Myeongsik Choi of Korea, 17.5 kilograms behind. Now that is just amazing. That's 40 pounds. That's about 3 stone difference. So that is a huge margin.
Representing China, Liu Xiuhua.
Liu Xiuhua, with this extraordinary performance, a world record total of 187.5 and a 10 kilogram margin over Guan Hong, who will win the silver medal overall.
The silver medal, with once again a short-lived world's record of 177.5 kilograms, representing China, Guan Hong.
Guan Hong took the gold in the snatch when Liu Xiuhua decided not to proceed after her first snatch of 77.5. And Guan Hong could have competed in the 46-kilogram division and won the gold.
With a total of 170 kilos, which was also a short-lived world record, as we had 15 world records exceeded in this category, representing Chinese Taipei, Kuo Chu Chuen.
And she was 17.5 kilograms behind the winner. China won to Taipei, taking the bronze overall in the women's 50-kilogram division. A total of 15 world records broken in that women's division. Tomorrow, the long-awaited appearance of the Pele of international weightlifting, Naim Süleymanoğlu from Turkey. He was the athlete of the games at the Seoul Olympics in 1988, breaking the world record with every lift, and he's unbeaten in competition since 1983. Join us for our live coverage, a rare opportunity to see one of the all-time greats tomorrow. Until then, Gordon Bray for ABC Sport. Welcome to day three of the World Weightlifting Championships, which were set alight by the appearance of the mighty Turk Naim Süleymanoğlu. He appeared in the men's 64-kilogram division. We'll also see highlights tonight of the women's 54 kgs. Joining me is Robert Kabas. And Robert, a fantastic session of weightlifting featuring one of the all-time greats.
Yes, certainly. I think so far in this championship, this has been the closest competition as far as all weightlifters being in contention for the medals, and the final result not settled until the very last lift.
Yes, there was plenty of drama there. Let's go to the start list for this 64 kg A division. And who should we look out for apart from Naim?
Well, obviously the man of the moment is Naim Süleymanoğlu, but all the men are in contention, particularly Attila Chanka, who's got the current world standard in the snatch. Valerios Leonidis, very strong in the clean and jerk. And probably an unknown quantity here is He Bongri from North Korea.
Yes, this man was born in the mountain region of Bulgaria, where there was a high concentration of ethnic Turks. His father, a miner, stood just 5 feet tall, or 1.5 meters. His mother worked in a hothouse. She was 4 feet 7 and a half, but Naim is his father's height. And at the age of 14, he came within 2.5 kilograms of the adult world record for combined lifts. At 15, he set his first world record, and at 16, he became the second person in history to clean and jerk three times his own body weight. This is Yurik Sarkisian from Armenia. His first attempt at 135.
Sarkisian represented the USSR at the 1980 Olympics in Moscow and was a silver medalist there in the 56 kilo class. He then moved up to the 60 kilogram class and won the world championship in 1983. So he's been around for a long time and perhaps just a little bit past his best, but certainly nothing wrong with that lift.
Well, that's the most confident lift we've seen so far in 64Ks.
Now, with that lift, he moves into first position. Having come from the 60 kilo class, he probably would have had no trouble making the limit here, but he's still the lightest of the lifters that have lifted so far, and this moves him immediately into first place.
Second attempt then for Fedel Gula of Turkey. Having missed at 135, he'll now attempt the same weight.
Now the pressure is right on him because you can see so far all the men have tackled the same weight. And it's the man who's going to hold his nerve best and make the least number of mistakes that's going to win. He's already behind the eight ball.
Now for the Turk with two failures, he faces the prospect of bombing out in this snatch. This is Yuyi Zhang of China, who is comfortably under the 64 kilogram limit at 63.74, 137.5 the bar for his first attempt. This man holds the clean and jerk world standard, which is his strongest lift. Of China, well pleased with that first up effort, a confident start for him.
And he should be well pleased because technically it was correct, but also the weight looked very, very light. He had plenty of room to spare, and with the clean and jerk being a strong discipline for him, then he'll be very happy with that start.
Valeris Leonidis of Greece. First attempt at 137.5. He's also very strong in the clean and jerk and shares that world mark with Yu Yi.
Leonidis is the current silver medalist from the recent European Championships, so he's been in good form this year. Face after that first attempt. I think he'd already gone up 2.5 kilograms on the weight that he nominated, and really it looked almost like a maximum start.
That's an unusual smile with your cheeks blowing out like that. Have a look at this.
I'm not so sure that it is a smile.
Attila Csonka, the Hungarian. And the bar has moved up to 140 kilograms for his first attempt.
Now what Attila has done there, he's pointed to his elbow and drawn the referee's attention that that's as far as he can extend it. In other words, it's not possible for him to really lock out his elbow because otherwise the judges would not give him the down signal or disqualify him. He has had an injury, I believe he dislocated that elbow and he just cannot straighten it out. If we have a look there, it looks as if it's not extended. And had he not pointed that out to the referees, they may have felt that the lift was not completed and given him a red line.
Same weight, 140 kilos.
Well, it really was an impressive lift here.
It was,
as Hungarian.
As you would expect from him, he is the current world record holder in this lift.
And now the moment we've been waiting for. Naim Sulemeoglu. First attempt at 140, and the Royal Exhibition Building will erupt when he appears.
The supremely confident weightlifter, as we've said before. Almost makes a point of being the last lifter to start, to establish from the very outset of the competition who's in charge.
Naim Süleymanoğlu from Turkey. What a start by the Olympic champion. Just the fillip for his band of supporters.
And with his first attempt, he moves straight away into first place. It didn't look a particularly easy attempt, but for a man of his size and proportions, where he really, because of the length of his arms, he really can't generate that much change in speed. He's really a one-speed lifter. He's got to really yank it off the platform and get it overhead. His lifts don't always look particularly easy, but they always look solid and under control, so it can be no guide to what he's going to do with his next attempt.
So the Korean now, Ri Hee Bong, he's achieved 135 and 140. Can he keep up his 100% record with his final lift at 142.5?
He's looked pretty solid right through, so I think he's got a good show at getting this. Looks confident.
The Koreans have been very impressive. And that lift puts him into the lead.
Very, very happy with that, and I think he's executed a perfect series of snatches. That looked to be right on his limit, and that's the art in weightlifting, to be able to use up those three attempts that you've got as wisely as possible, so you don't start too high.
Yui Zhang of China, who missed this weight at his second attempt, really wants this third one because he has cleared only 137.5. So he's going to be struggling overall if he doesn't successfully get this weight of 142.5.
He had a respectable go at the second one. He just seemed, the weight just seemed to be traveling in front of him all the time. He never really pulled it close to himself and gave himself a chance of getting it.
He's very focused this time, and that is a fighting lift from the Chinese. Yui Zhang, 142.5. And that gives him the lead because he has a lower body weight than the Korean.
Well, he's very happy with himself, and the coaches were extremely happy with him. And as the current world leader in the clean and jerk, he would have to be very optimistic with his chances for the competition. He will move in front at
40. Yes, the pressure was really on him, and he answered the call.
Radistan Dimitrov from Bulgaria, 142.5, his third and last attempt. Failed at his second attempt at this weight.
We drew attention to the taping on his right hand, and we just think it's giving him a little bit of discomfort, especially in the snatch with the wide grip.
So he has to live with his first lift of 137.5 after failing twice at 142.5. Naim Süleymanoğlu, the world and Olympic champion now, attempting 145. He has cleared 140. This will take over the outright lead with one lift remaining. Meticulous preparation.
Oh yes, the Superman from Turkey. He just looked at his thumb there. He felt a bit of pain. But the Royal Exhibition Building erupts for their hero.
Good fighting lift.
Well, he's obviously not happy about something, and it's that right hand.
That's right. I mean, with his at his size, he always experiences problems because he's got such small hands to get them round about the bar, and he may have just torn a little bit of a callus or some of his skin, which is annoying him a little bit. The question is whether he'll take a third attempt or not. He'll definitely take a third attempt if Chunker gets this. But should Chunker miss it, I don't know whether Naeem would come out for a third attempt or not. Just save it for the clean and jerk, perhaps.
Well, he has a lead of 2.5 kilograms at the moment over his nearest rival. Last attempt for Chunker at 145. He missed his second one. So he'll have to be satisfied with a lift of 140. And let's see if Naeem Sulaymanoglu is going to attempt an increase with his last attempt or whether he elects to proceed to the clean and jerk. Sally Penson, how's it looking down there? What are you expecting?
Sulaymanoglu has walked straight out of the warm-up area. He's not going to take his third attempt. He's quite satisfied. He'll try and recoup his energy for the clean and jerk.
And here the standings after the snatch, and Naeem Sulaymanoglu from Turkey is the leader at 145, which equals the world record. And he only had two attempts. Zhang Yuyi from China in second place, and Hebong Ri of North Korea in third place. But with me, Robert Kabas, who is watching on with fascination there. Robert, I'm just wondering about the Olympic champion, whether maybe he's not done the work that we thought he might have.
Well, I think that you've probably hit the nail on the head there. He's always under pressure to compete. He doesn't like to let his Turkish fans down, so he's probably come into this competition just a little bit underdone, and he's quite happy at this stage to have the lead in the snatch.
I really gained the impression with his first lift in the snatch that he was extremely relieved when he got that bar over his head at 140 kilograms, because there's a lot of pressure on him, isn't there?
There certainly is. As we said before, the bigger the reputation, the bigger the pressure, as we saw recently with Michael Jordan, and he's tried to alleviate that sort of thing by taking his continuous breaks from weightlifting, but at the same time that means he's always got to be starting almost from scratch. But he's talented enough and strong enough naturally to be able to still compete and lead the world.
One point that interests me, how much of an advantage is it having short arms for these little guys, particularly in the
well,
snatch?
Well, I'm not so sure that it is an advantage. It has its benefits and, its side effects. Having such short arms, he cannot generate that much speed to try and get under the weight, but also he's got less distance to travel at the same time. I think it's not his short arms, it's short arms compared to his long torso, and that's what helps him. Yurik Sarkisyan from Armenia, former world champion, 170 kilograms, and I would have to say that this would be a fairly high start for him. He's normally evenly balanced in his abilities in both the snatch and the clean and jerk, but going by past performances, this would normally test him as a first attempt. Although, of course, he's competing at the 64-kilo class, whereas he used to compete at 60 kilos, so maybe the extra body weight traditionally helps you more in the clean and jerk. And that was quite an easy clean. And a good solid jerk, so he really is in good form.
Good lift for Sarkisyan, 170 kilos.
This moves him into second place, just 2.5 kilograms behind Rihi Bong and ahead of Yuyi Zhang on body weight. Of course, there are still Chunker to start and Sulaymanoglu.
Strong clean. And he finished off nicely.
Yes, well done.
The lifter to follow will be Attila Tsanga.
So now Feng Ming of China.
Tsanga Magiroshag Elkisu.
Successful with his first attempt at 167.5. His second here at 170.
Now I believe this will establish a new junior world record. Feng Ming is only 18 years of age. And he's chosen to take just a 2.5 kilogram increase from his first attempt, which was probably a wise thing because the clean was just a little bit difficult with his first one. and it's a bit of a struggle again as he leans to one side. But he showed us that he can jerk with his last attempt. And he does.
Well, that is determination personified there from Feng Ming of China, the 18-year-old. And smiles all round from the Chinese team.
And he seemed to time it perfectly with the signal as to, as to when he put it down. So he didn't hold it for a split second longer than he had to.
So the bar at 172.5 for Feng Ming from China. And this would exceed the world junior record total.
He looks like a likely customer, this guy. Probably someone to watch for the future. Only 18 years of age. And he showed plenty of fight. He could have been disappointed after his snatches and maybe spat the dummy a bit, but he's decided to fight right through every lift. That one just a little bit too heavy. Perhaps he was a bit too happy with his last lift, and it probably did drain his energies.
And the little man who took the gold medal in the snatch, Naim Solomonoglu, still hasn't come out to the platform for his first lift.
He did, though, look almost ready to come out. He's got the tracksuit on, so we should expect him soon. Possibly after this lift.
So Zhang Yuyi needs this final attempt at 172.5 to take the lead.
Once again, comfortable up to here. Now we'll see whether he's juked. No, he's starting to wobble a little bit.
Yes, once he started walking, it was expending energy. And so a disappointment there for the man who held the clean and jerk world standard. So Süleymanoğlu idolized by the Turkish fans.
And here we have Mehmet Yaksi, a member of the Australian team, but of Turkish origin.
First attempt for the dual Olympic and world champion at 175 kilograms.
Of course, this will give him the lead straight away. And he'll have quite a comfortable buffer over the others, and he can dictate the terms of the competition from here. And it also means that his second attempt at whatever weight he takes will become a new world record.
So this lift to equal the world standard, 19 seconds.
He's taking his time. He doesn't want to waste the attempt. He wants to make sure of this, so it takes the pressure right off him. He can have the world title more or less safe, and then he can concentrate on world records.
This will catapult him to the lead. He only just beat the clock. Well, a disappointment there. And that's putting it mildly for Naim Süleymanoğlu at 175.
It's a disappointment and a surprise. 175 kilograms normally within his reach, but it's a very, very big weight as we realize for someone his weight. It is the current world standard, so he wasn't starting conservatively or with, you know, with kids' weights. But just a little bit not there, and I think we hinted that he probably wasn't in top shape. He's had a lot of other commitments in Turkey, and a lot of the times he's also mentioned that he did want to retire, so he's in a really pressure situation. But now we have the other Turkish lifter on the platform, Fidel Güler, who's jumped 15 kilograms from his starting attempt. I almost thought that he'd retired from the competition because we hadn't seen him for a while, so he would have had to go back, rest, and virtually start warming up all over again. but now he's vying for a medal in the clean and jerk.
Well, this is an increase of about 2.5 stone under the old measurement from his first attempt.
So 175 kilograms. Some good fighting clean.
And he's equaled the world standard, jumping up 15 kilograms. At last, the Turks have something to cheer about in this clean and jerk.
Now, what a shame it is that he couldn't register one snatch attempt, because he would have been right in the running in this competition. And some of the weightlifting people even thought that he would be challenging Suleiman Oğlu before this competition. He came here with the reputation of being a new strong comer, but obviously nerves got to him in the snatch. In the clean and jerk, he's relaxed a little bit, and he's come out with a wonderful attempt in the clean and jerk.
So Valerius Leonidis from Greece, second attempt at 175. He's cleared 170, but still quite a leeway to make up here. He's trailing by 5 kilograms.
Now, if he's successful, it'll give him 312 and a half kilograms in the total. He's the very lightest man in the competition. Suleiman Oğlu hasn't totaled yet, so it puts him in the lead. And there it is.
And if Suleiman Oğlu doesn't lift 175, that could have been a golden lift. Time will tell.
What a fantastic lift. I mean, looking at this guy, he really hasn't got anything going for him physically. He's not overly muscular. He hasn't got really flashy technique, but he's just getting there on pure fighting abilities.
175 remains on the barbell. For the second attempt.
And this is probably one of the best lifts of the whole competition so far. Now, this man has looked the most consistent, really, of all in this weight division, and if things come down to the wire where the smallest mistake is going to count, I think you'd have to be backing this guy.
He's looked infallible so far with 4 straight successes. This is his second attempt clean and jerk, 175.
There again, he's looked solid. He hasn't displayed any weaknesses anywhere, really.
And we have a new leader.
Are getting tough. If Suleiman Oğlu doesn't register a jerk, and certainly we'd be hoping that he can, but if he doesn't, this is the guy that you want to be looking at. He's come out of nowhere, really. No one has mentioned him in any of the pre-competition predictions, but he's looked solid right through. He's got on with the business, and he's our new leader.
And it's Yurik Sarkisian from Armenia who has a lower body weight, so he can take the lead here.
Well, actually, he can take second place.
Second place.
Yeah, this will give him 315. But I think he's got to sort of juggle, should he go for first place or what he realistically thinks he can achieve here. He still has 2 attempts, so he can perhaps get as much as he can here and then hope for a bigger on his third. But he's struggling, he's struggling. And I think the judge has really made him earn it. He's got 1 red light. I think if we look at the replay, the reason for that 1 red light is his right arm, he has the same trouble, but not to the same extent as Chanka, where his right arm, he cannot really straighten it out, and it makes it very, very hard to hold it a maximum clean and jerk with bent arms. Here we watch his left arm, it's wobbling a little bit. What probably saves him from getting 3 red lights is that he didn't bend it and then re-straighten it, which would have been a cause for disqualification.
So now it's Attila Csonka from Hungary, the European champion. The bar at 175.
Now
his first on 172.5 wasn't as easy as probably he would have expected. He's going up the minimum increase of 2.5 kilograms, 175. This will give him a total of 315, so he still won't go into the lead. It'll stay with Rihi Bong. And a strong clean again.
He's given himself a chance for a minor medal, and he's delighted about that. Equaling the world record standard, Attila Csonka from Hungary. He totals 315, but trails by 2.5 kilograms overall.
He's very happy with that clean and jerk. It's very close to his personal best. Puts him in third place, but I guess he's got to be happy with what he can get now, because he couldn't perform in this snatch, his best lift.
If he succeeds, he will set a new world record for the clean and jerk, and a new
so
world
Suleyman record Oglu, for the total. After missing his first attempt at 175, has gone up 2.5 kilograms. He's gone to 177.5, which would be a new world record. It would also put him into a lead which should give him the gold medal.
Now, has he gone up that 2.5 kilograms because he's annoyed with himself and he wants to make a point here? Or did he think it will give him that little bit of extra time to recuperate? We don't know, but I guess in the wash-up, 2.5 kilograms, he figures isn't going to make that much difference to whether he's going to make it or not.
This would give him a 5 kilogram lead over the Korean Rihi Bong.
And it's not particularly easy.
Yes, he fought it, and he's done it. And that is surely the gold medal for the magnificent Turk, who's below his best here. But he showed what a great competitor he is. Breaking the world record, and now in the gold medal position.
And what a reaction from the crowd. I think everyone really wanted him to make that lift. No one likes to see a champion go down under these circumstances. If he's going to ever get beaten, someone has to earn that right.
Well, that, you would think, should clinch the gold medal, because he has a lower body weight than the Korean, who's also looked very strong.
Yes,
this was one of the lifts of the championship so far. So whether his countryman, Fadel Gula, has been inspired by that performance at 177.5, we'll soon know. This man lifted 175. He's gone up 2.5. Final attempt. But he can be very pleased with his lift at 175.
No lift.
Yes, I think it's just a shame that, as we said before, that he couldn't get a lift in the snatch, because he would have been right into this competition. But he'll be happy with 175.
And finally, if Leonidas succeeds, he goes into first place on the clean and jerk in front of Suleyman.
177.5 for Valerius Leonidas from Greece.
People's Republic of Korea.
But it looks as though only one man can beat Suleyman Oglu, and that is Rihi Bong, realistically.
This lift would move Leonidis into first place in the clean and jerk over Suleyman Oglu on virtue of his lighter body weight, and third place overall.
Rihi Bong cannot overtake Suleyman Oglu.
Yes, he's chosen to concede the gold in both the clean and jerk and the snatch, and rather opt out and consolidate his second placing, because the competition is still wide open, with both Sarkisian and Csonka
having a chance of overtaking Rihi Bong. So if he took a chance and went for the gold, he might miss out on a medal altogether. Once again, a solid cleaner. This would give him a perfect afternoon. And what a shame he couldn't do. He's annoyed.
So he did clear 175. And his total of 317.5 still has to be overtaken by those other lifters.
The bar's loaded still to 177.5. He looked happy with his last attempt. It wasn't too heavy, and this would take second place away from Rihi Bong. Chunke is lighter. He needs this for the overall silver medal. His only problem is that right arm, whether he can support the weight overhead, so we look for it here as he tries to hit the split position in the jerk. It's not there.
So he can't take the second place. He was 200 grams lighter than Rihi Bong. So the Korean still holding down the silver medal position.
Sarkisian has decided to withdraw from the competition and not attempt this weight of 180 kilograms. Sulimanlu has decided that two world records...
But I am surprised that Sarkisian didn't attempt 177.5.
So the message has come through to the crowd outside that their hero has taken the gold medal. Sally Penson.
Yes, here we are in the warm-up room with our world champion, Naeem. Sorry to catch you with no clothes on. Are you happy with your lifting today?
Yeah, very happy.
Are you disappointed that they did not push you to lift a heavier weight?
Yok, üzgün değilim. Yani bu benim için yeterli olsun. Fazla gerek yok zaten. Kaldırırım, sen de kaldırma.
Quite happy with what he's done. He could possibly lift a bit more, but why?
Are you injured? Are you fully fit for this competition today?
No injuries whatsoever.
Well, congratulations. Fantastic.
Scenes of elation here in Melbourne. As the hero of Turkey, he's a national hero there, has clinched his place and setting world records to boot.
Yes, on paper it looks a comfortable victory, but I think in real terms it had its moment of drama with Naeem missing his first attempt in the clean and jerk and really having to push himself virtually to the limit to secure that second clean and jerk of 177.5. But overall I think he's fulfilled 99.9% of the crowd's wishes, and no one can be disappointed with that performance.
Naeem Sulaymanoglu from Turkey comes up towards the winner's dais. And this 54-kilogram division for women expected to be dominated by the Chinese athlete Qian Xiaomin, the Chinese winning 1-2 in the 50-kilogram division last night. Joining me is Sally Penson, and talking of that 50-kilogram, you've uncovered a hard luck story.
Yes, I have. Unfortunately, Kunjarani from India didn't get to Australia in time to lift in the 46-kilo class, and so she had to be satisfied to lift in the heavier weight class. If she had lifted in the 46-kilo class, she would have won 3 gold medals.
Well, that really is bad luck for her. She was obviously held up without that visa in India.
Yes, that was the problem, apparently.
OK. Well, Australia had 2 competitors in the B division in this 54 kilograms. Let's firstly look at Dr. Diana Loy, who hails from Brisbane. This is her third attempt at 67.5 in the snatch, and this to equal her personal best.
Yes, Diana has missed this on her second attempt. She's the pressure is on her to get this lift, which will be her equal personal best. It's an easy pull. Not a clean lift, but definitely she had the strength to come up out of it.
Successful attempt. Yes, she's a first-generation Australian, Dr. Diana Loy.
And we can see that she pulls the bar close to her body, but slightly forward as she comes up for a recovery, which made it a little bit more difficult than it could have been.
Now, this is Jay Dicker, who also competed in the B division from Western Australia. She's an ex-state javelin champion. And like Sally Penson, who was an ex-state discus champion.
Yes, Jay is very inexperienced compared to Diana Loy. She's lifting slightly less weight than her in the total. But Jay's got a big future ahead of her. She's very strong. She's very determined. We can see this, the way she struggles with the bar, but finally does make the weight.
Yes, well, some encouraging performances from the Australians. They're not in the top bracket, but they are around PBs, if not better.
Yes, they did personal bests for their totals. They really are using this as an experience.
Well, let's have a look at the A division start list now. And Qian Xiaomin from China is the red-hot favourite, but Robin Bird has been around for a while and is certainly capable of putting the pressure on.
Robin Bird has been one of the 12 girls that have lifted in every single world championship, this being her seventh, so she's very experienced. Also, the Indian lifter, Kanam Malaswari, will be in contention for a minor medal.
So now, Kuechi Wang from Taipei, after missing at 75 with her second attempt, has her final lift in the snatch. Same weight. Looking to get the bar high here.
Oh yes, that was a nasty drop for Kuechi. The bar rolled along her neck, but she should be all right. She dipped her head and it rolled off quite easily. It's a bit frightening. Luckily that the hair provides an easy path for the bar to slide across.
And luckily she's got quick reflexes. Yanita Georgieva from Bulgaria. She missed her first attempt due to a timing problem. She actually didn't take the attempt. She did complete 80 and her third lift now at 82.5, which will put her up into second position.
Oh yes, and that's a fine lift from Yanita. She's a tremendous competitor. The pressure is on her to do that lift. She'd just seen somebody else have a go and drop it, and the Chinese girl had easily lifted 80 kilos.
That's actually put her in the lead because she has a lighter body weight than Qian Xiaomin. But one suspects only on sufferance because this young lady has looked very impressive. Kanam Malaswari and Qian Xiaomin lifted her first attempt at 82.5 very convincingly. So the Indian looking to take the lead.
Oh, look, that's a beautiful lift. She deserves that lift. Her technique is just superb. She's strong, very happy with that lift, and so she should be.
Same weight on the bar, 82.5 kilos. Third attempt for Robin Bird, USA.
Her technique is just tremendous. You know, I'd like my girls at school to be watching this tonight because she is really terrific, that Indian lady.
Big lift now for Robin Bird of the United States. She knows she can take this weight, 82.5. And this will also put her in the lead if successful.
Robin's looking very aggressive. Now, she really must get this weight if she's in the running for anything. And she's capable of doing it. Yes, yes.
Yes, she got it. No. Hold it.
Yes, move your feet.
Well, that was a courageous effort from Robin Bird.
And she gets three white lights. I really thought that her feet weren't parallel. That's why I was saying move your feet.
She made heavy weather of it.
Yes, very heavy weather. Look at that. That took an enormous amount of guts to keep that bar above her head. She's elated. So she should be.
Oh,
That's a very determined lifter there.
So now the Chinese champion, the 16-year-old Qian Xiaomin, who will have her second attempt at a whopping 87.5 kilos. This will be a world record lift. And she's gone up 5 kilograms. She did her first so easily at 82 and a half. So the 16-year-old will catapult herself to the lead here at her second attempt. All of the other lifters have finished in the snatch.
And doesn't she look calm and composed? Recognizes the crowd, gives the crowd a little bow. That's just courtesy.
Hook grip.
Yeah, we can see a hook grip on the bar.
Awesome.
Yes, the only word you can use to describe, I think, that lift. There's a lot more that that this young lady could do. These Chinese are holding back. They can lift a lot more than what we see them lifting here.
So the schoolgirl from China has taken a 5 kilogram lead, and she's going up just 2.5 now for her third attempt.
It looks like Karnam from India may have injured her knee slightly in that snatch, although there didn't seem to be any problems with it. It might be just a precaution she's taking as she's warming up for a clean and jerk.
So I'm into Chen China with Nightingale. Once again, she succeeds a new world record.
So she's already broken the world record with her previous snatch, and now her third and final attempt, 90 kilograms.
She must be feeling confident. She's hardly used any of the 2 minutes allowed to her, if she's following herself.
She fought it, but she's done it again in style. Some anxiety early on.
Yes, the catch wasn't as good as the other ones, but she managed to control that weight as if it was nothing. I'm sure she could snatch a lot more than this.
Her second world record in the snatch with this final lift, and she takes the gold medal as well.
Yes, a beautiful extension, bar slightly backwards, so she has to move it forward before she stands up, and a bow to the crowd.
Well, the Chinese lifters haven't shown a lot of emotion traditionally, but perhaps a semblance of a smile there. We're only halfway through the serious business, a clean and jerk to come, but a sense of relief there for this champion, 16-year-old from China. A whopping 7.5 kilogram advantage to Chen Xiaomin from China. Robin Bird with that last snatch gets the silver in the snatch because of her lower body weight, ahead of Malaswari of India and Georgieva from Bulgaria. And now to the clean and jerk. There's Chen Xiaomin just warming up, building up for her first attempt, which will come later. She was the last lifter, and she was 7.5 clear in the snatch. But this is the Indian, the 18-year-old Karnam Malaswari, in third place after the snatch, 95 kilograms here.
Yes, it's an easy clean from Carmen. And a beautiful jerk. Those elbows are in a perfect reverse lockout position. And as I expected, as we expected that there was no problem with that first attempt.
She's really gunning for that silver medal because Qian Xiaomin looks a cut above these lifters, the Chinese. So she's going to have a battle with Robin Bird and also Yanita Georgieva from Bulgaria. Robin Bird with the bar at 95 kilograms here. Her first attempt in the clean and jerk. She has a lighter body weight than the Indian, so this would put her into first place, but the Chinese lifter hasn't appeared as yet.
Robin was successful with this weight in Varna last year. And as a first attempt, I would expect her to produce a routine attempt.
Very experienced lifter, and it shines through, competing in her seventh world championship, successful and going to the early lead overall.
Because I'm always concerned with Robin that she looks down so much. She looks down in the clean, and she'll look down as she jerks the bar above her head also.
So now we have Yanita Georgieva of Bulgaria. Her first attempt at 95. Plenty of noise, and it did the trick.
Yes, it certainly was not an easy attempt, and she's hobbling off. It looks like that left knee or hip is giving her a few problems. That was a difficult first attempt for Yanita.
Now, she was in fourth place after the snatch.
Yes, you can see that she really is struggling, and really good technique has kept her in good stead in that lift. She doesn't look to be comfortable there. Perhaps there's an injury of some sort there.
This to give her a total of 180, which would increase her lead. But we still haven't seen 16-year-old Chen Xiaomin. This will go a long way towards that silver medal.
That's a difficult clean. She's really going to have to push hard with the jerk. Oh, it was a valiant effort, but just too far in front to catch.
Contortions from her coach during the lift.
Unbelievable. Look at this.
It's about to be dropped. ...97.5. She's got a fighting chance here.
Yes, and I think that bar just grazed her lower back as it went down. She's not had a good run today with the bar hitting the body, that's for sure. And she's holding herself a bit upright, so maybe she's got a little bit of bruising there too. But what a valiant effort from this young lady. It's an enormous weight for a 54-kilo class.
Robin Bird from the United States. And this is a critical lift because she can take over the front running here. Her third and final attempt will also be a world record in the clean and jerk and a world record total. Grand campaigner. Robin Bird, just 23 years of age, she failed at 97.5. The bar at 100 kilograms.
Oh, that's just difficult. No.
No lift for
Bird. As you can see, she's upset. But I think this is a much better performance from her this year. There's been improvement over the years since we saw her in Varna.
Now, that still may be good enough to give her the silver medal. It's down to a body weight situation if her nearest opponents miss with their final attempt.
Certainly, Kana Malaswari has looked in excellent form during this competition. She's successful with this weight of 100 kilos. She will have 182.5 kilo total, placing her in front of Robin Bird.
So this for the silver medal. Not to be. So now a chance for this lady to take the silver medal. We're assuming that Chen Xiaomin will successfully complete one lift in the clean and jerk. We haven't seen her so far. So can she overtake Robin Bird here?
That's a difficult clean. Yes, Yanita is lifting at her uppermost limit. And she has given all today. She's really put in 110% effort.
So she completes at 177.5.
As we can see, there's been a lot of strength used just getting up out of the clean. Not quite enough legs left to hold the bar above the head.
And now this lady, who hasn't been seen so far in the clean and jerk competition, the other lifters have all finished, and a world record attempt coming up here with her first try at 105 kilograms. Qian Xiaomin from China, 16-year-old schoolgirl, 105 kilograms first attempt. She just needs this one to not only take a gold medal, but also shatter the world record.
Oh, and that's a beautiful lift, and very easy. I wonder if she'll take any more attempts or if she'll be satisfied with this first winning lift of hers.
So two world records, a total, and also the clean and jerk, a new mark of 105. Remember that all the weight divisions have been reclassified. And she's going up to 107.5 after that great lift. It's a matter of how far for this champion lifter from China, Qian Xiaomin.
Yes, this is keeping to our predictions of a Chinese haul of medals. And there's a little bit more effort needed for 110. Yes, she's had to work a lot harder in this lift. At last we see a bit of strain from Qian Xiaomin. And she's happy with that. First sign of emotion from her today.
And that gives her a round total of 200 so far. She completed 90 in the snatch and 110 with this lift.
I was at the press conference for the Chinese winners yesterday, and 10,000 women lift in China.
So she has definitely wrapped things up. She's into a tracksuit. She's having a drink. And we can confirm then she's not going to attempt a final lift. Official confirmation, Qian Xiaomin, 22 and a half kilograms ahead of her nearest rival, Robin Bird of the United States. Malaswari from India getting the bronze medal with a lighter body weight from Yanita Georgieva of Bulgaria.
Representing China, Xiaomin Chen.
A clean sweep of the gold medals for the Chinese teenager. World records in the snatch, clean and jerk, and the total.
And each medal winner also gets some of Leslie's travel products as a bonus.
So three glittering gold medals.
It's a triumphant day for Turkey and China. And Sally Penson, there is a parallel because Naeem was 16 years of age when he won his first world title.
Yes, and Chen, with her first world title today, is also 16 years of age. And Chen comes from a pool of 10,000 women weightlifters in China.
Well, tomorrow we have the 59 kilogram division. China also expected to do well. And also the 70 kgs. And all the action tomorrow night at the same time here on ABC television. Gordon Bray for ABC Sport.
This is Fox Rich.
And it was geared towards overseas markets. However, very little labour was required. The actual price.
Welcome to day four of the World Weightlifting Championships, and tonight we focus on 59 kilograms for women and 70 k's for men. And so far, 41 world records have been set, 25 of those by the women, and the Chinese ladies have 17 of those 25. And we have another one going round tonight, Kayan Soon, but she has a fairly fierce rival. Joining me is Sally Penson, the Australian champion in 76 k's. There's going to be a good grudge match here tonight, Sally, I think.
Yes, Maria Cristoforetti is really out to beat the Chinese if she can. I don't think she will, but certainly she'll have a good competition with the Chinese Taipei girl and the Bulgarian.
Well, Maria is a former world champion, but earlier good news in the B division by Australia's Debbie Smith.
Yes, Debbie's my training partner at the VIS Hawthorne Weightlifting Club, and she has snatched 77 kilos in the past month or so, but unfortunately has suffered a number of minor injuries leading into this competition.
Excellent attempt here in the snatch.
Yes, that's the strongest I've seen Debbie lift for a number of weeks now, and as you can see, she's elated with that lift.
Well, Debbie, no nonsense when she gets out onto the platform. She really means business. Her third attempt at 97.5 to take the lead.
Yes, Debbie's been a weightlifter for 10 years or more now. She's one of the most experienced in our team, and she's a very dedicated athlete. She's in the gym every night. She takes her training seriously. Of course, you have to at this level, and this lift was a good one for her, and it's the strongest I've seen her for a number of weeks now. Yes, and that's a solid jerk from Debbie. She'll be absolutely thrilled to finish first in this B group.
Splendid performance by Debbie, but here's the A group in the women's 59 kilograms. And Kayan Soon, the 19-year-old China, certainly the person to beat. But Maria Cristoforidou from Greece will have plenty of opposition for those minor medals. First appearance of Kayan Soon, the Chinese favourite here in the women's 59 kilogram division. The Chinese women have been breaking world records, setting new standards all over the place, and much expected of the third lightest competitor in this 59 kilogram division.
I saw Soon Kayin training during the week, and this 90 kilo first attempt should provide very little difficulty for her. It's a routine attempt.
Kayan Soon of China, first attempt at 90 kilograms in the snatch. This to take the lead. Formidable lift by the Chinese, and there's a lot more left.
Good lift.
Yes, in keeping with the other Chinese athletes we've seen lifting, the women, there appears to be very little strain in lifting this weight.
She has cleared 85, which places her 5 kilograms behind, but she desperately wants this one to stay in serious contention for those medals.
Well, she's out of a medal if she doesn't get this weight.
Third and final attempt for Maria Cristoforidou from Greece, 90 kilograms.
Yes.
And she fought it. Superb effort by Maria.
Maria Cristoforidou with 90 kilos.
Yes, that time she got the bar moving a lot faster, pulled it a lot higher.
92.5 kilos.
And a catch, although still awkward, was there that time. And that's a seasoned competitor we're watching.
The third and final attempt here will put her into the lead over China's Kayan.
You see the coach give her an almighty slap on the back just to get her going. She's stomping some rosin into her shoes just to make sure there's no slipping of the feet during the lift.
Kayan of China is the leader. Cristoforidou of Greece in second place. Kirillova is the new leader.
92.5, her final attempt.
And a world record.
A world record to boot. Bulgaria. Gergana Kirillova, splendid effort there.
Yes, that's 12 and a half kilos in excess of her lift last year. So she's been training hard this year and really, really responded well.
95 kilograms.
Yes, this is still a toying weight for Soon Kyan, and I have no doubt it will be successful.
And the prospect of her going up maybe even another 5 kilograms if successful here. At the moment, Kirillova is in the lead, but she's going for 5 extra kilos. 95 kilograms. This would give her a 2.5 lead. This her second attempt. Kyan, oh, that was just so easy, Sally.
Yes, just one little step forward, but always under control. No hint of dropping the weight there.
Kirillova's world record is gone after just over a minute. World record. The way she's lifted with her first two attempts, this one you'd think would almost be a formality as well. Shattering the world record by 7.5 kilograms. That's the old world record if successful here. Third and final attempt for Kyan of China, 97.5.
Yes, 5 kilos more than her lift in Varna last year, her winning snatch of last year. And even though we think it's going to be routine, she still has to do a good job here. It's a heavy weight.
Good lift and another world record for
well, the crowd applauding this Chinese lifter. And you get the impression that there's certainly more left, although she's shattered the world record by 7.5 kilograms. The Chinese women dominating in these divisions so far. And a phenomenal snatch of 97.5. In second place, Gergana Kirillova. That 92.5 was a world record for a short while. And Maria Christofaridou of Greece in third place and taking the bronze medal in the snatch. Next, the clean and jerk. She's gone up 2.5 kilograms from her previous success, and she's indicated so far that she's going to manage this weight.
Well, the pressure is now off a little bit for Maria Christofaridou. And I'm surprised that Gergana didn't give that a better go. Maybe, you know, the 5 good lifts that she's executed have just taken a little bit of energy away from her for that last big lift.
So she finishes with a total of 202.5. And now Maria Christofaridou, after that unsuccessful lift by the Bulgarian, has the chance to take over the lead and clinch at least a silver medal.
So I suppose the pressure's really still on her here, not off her. This is a silver medal attempt.
It's a good clean.
And she knows. There goes the silver medal.
No lift for Christofaridou.
So, she can't believe that. She has cleared that weight before. And the Bulgarian knows that she's still in the lead and has got at least a silver. But this would put her 17.5 kilograms above the world record total, which is quite staggering.
Yes, all these Chinese girls have got very strong legs. They're quite diminutive in size and appearance, but supreme athletes. on the weightlifting platform.
120 kilograms, second attempt. Sun Kaiyan, China.
Once again, that high push with the bar to adjust it onto her shoulders.
She's very aggressive. Surprise miss.
No lift.
Yes, that is a surprise miss.
She is human after all.
Isn't it wonderful to see some human qualities here? I think that must be the first dropped lift we've seen from a Chinese athlete so far in this World Championship. A female athlete, I should qualify.
Third and final attempt, 120 kilos for new world's records on jerk and total.
So the crowd wondering whether Kaiyan can produce this world record, which would be 10 kilograms above the old standard. Last attempt, 120 kilograms.
Yes, we can hear there's a little bit of grunting going on, which means the weight isn't light for her.
She made light of it third time round, though. Again beating her world record.
And a good lift and two more world records.
Another impressive performance by the Chinese. World records going
in the clean and jerk
with this fantastic lift.
The medal ceremonies will follow in a few moments.
It took a little bit more effort to stand up with that weight. But a jerk technique is so solid. Just a little bit of a sideways step to recover and no hint of unlocking those elbows or shoulders.
Sensational performance by Kaiyan Sun. A clean sweep of the gold medals and that one unsuccessful attempt in the clean and jerk at 120. But she made amends at her third and she has beaten Kirillova of Bulgaria by 15 kilograms, Maria Christofferidou of Greece in third place, and Abi Mami from Japan in fourth, and Debbie Smith from the B division up seventh in the world. Yes, and a lineup of seven starters at 70 kilograms. And the weightlifting will go right through until Sunday when we see the super heavyweights, the big men in action, and you can see live coverage here on ABC. Joining me now is Robert Cabas, and I know you're looking for big things from the Australians, three members of the Wild Bunch later in the week.
Yes, certainly. Kirill Kunev, Stefan Botev and Niku Vlad have been training very well, and they are all gold medal chances.
And what about Ron Laycock tomorrow?
Ron Laycock is a fighter, and I would class him as a definite outside medal chance, especially in the clean and jerk.
Well, let's have a look at the A classification for this 70 kilogram division. And who do you rate here?
I think with Israel Militosi and the Armenian Olympic champion missing, Yoto Yotov from Bulgaria would have to be the favourite here. And with possibly Andreas Bem from Germany, a former world record holder, to push him. And also Ergun Batmaz from Turkey.
Sian Chen, who must lift here to stay in contention overall. He's failed with his first two attempts at 145.
This is a real pressure lift. Possibly just a little bit closer than his other two tries, but really he didn't come close on any of his three attempts.
And the height was his problem again.
Third attempt for Andreas Bem, Germany. The lifter to follow will be Vasil Vasilev, Bulgaria.
Andreas Bem from Germany. He's cleared 140 and 145. He's gone up 2.5 kilograms here.
Now,
This is a really experienced lifter. He knows this lift is vital. And I'd probably be tempted to back him to get this one.
Andreas Bem, 147.5 to hit the lead. Last attempt.
Once again, he's taking plenty of time. He doesn't want to rush the lift. Waits for the 30-second buzzer so it doesn't break his concentration just as he's about to pull. Very deliberate lifter. Just 13 seconds left on the clock. Five, four. Oh, just misses it. Bad luck. This is Vasilov from Bulgaria. He missed his first attempt at this weight. And he missed it badly, really. So he would really have to regroup, think positively here. He's got the same hairstyle as Peshalov, the winner in the 59 kilo class, but it hasn't helped him.
Vasilev, second attempt at 150 after missing his first. A much better lift. A very determined young man.
Good lift for Vasilev.
On the board at 150.
Same weight, 150.
It was a good lift, but he just squeezed under it there. He's got a wide grip, and the bar just squeezed his head. Have a look at it here. By the time his arms have straightened, it's almost sitting behind his head.
That was a very critical lift because it's taken him into the lead with lighter body weight. Erkan Batmaz from Turkey can now regain that lead with a good one here at 150.
He was out very quickly. He knows what he did wrong on his first and he just wants to correct it as long as he doesn't rush it here. And he doesn't.
Robert Kabash, you predicted he would come good with that second one. Erkun Batmaz. And we have a new leader.
Yes, that's his first miss on it. The weight seemed to fly up, but I think he just relaxed that a little bit too early. This one here, he's much more determined, makes sure of it. And he's probably a little bit annoyed with himself for missing that first one.
Opportunity to hit the front here for Yoto Yotev of Bulgaria. He's currently in third place with the heaviest body weight of the three lifters who've all managed 150. But this can give him the outright lead by 5 kilograms. Second attempt. 155.
And just as importantly, if he hits the lead with this snatch, he's known as the strongest in the clean and jerk of all this group, so it'll put him in a very, very strong position. I'm sure the others would love to be ahead of him after the snatch.
Well, he's a marvelous athlete. Yoto Yotev of Bulgaria takes over.
Very, very determined lift. He looks like a man on a mission. He wants to prove to the world that he really should have won that gold medal at last year's Olympics, and he wants to win everything since then, including this world title.
So here's the man in his strongest lift who can take the gold medal here, or the gold medal position, with a good lift at 155. Yotov has cleared 155. This man is 5 kilograms behind, but he can equal it, and with a lighter body weight, takes the lead.
I give him a real chance of getting this. He's a very fast lifter. He looked confident after his second one, and I think he'd be kicking himself if he misses this one. Well, better start kicking.
Well, there's the gold medal in the snatch to Bulgaria with that failure by the Turk. 155 kilos. Yoto Yotov then, with a snatch of 155, taking the gold medal. Ergun Batmaz of Turkey, with a lighter body weight, gets the silver ahead of Vasil Vasilev of Bulgaria and Hakbong Kim of Korea in fourth spot. Interested spectator here this evening is Marcus Henry from the United States, the biggest weightlifter in the world. He was 170 kilograms when he lifted in the juniors. He's trimmed down to 165.
Dam Sonsu Kim Hakbong.
Currently in second place, 330 kilograms, his total, 182.5, attempted weight here. So he's going to try and consolidate in second and take the silver medal.
That's right. I think he's conceded the gold medal to Yotov. What he's trying to do is establish as much of a lead as he can over the guys chasing him. Now, his last lift was pretty close to his best. He's got to make sure that he doesn't relax and become satisfied with that and really push to get this one as well. Put another nail in the coffin. There's just that little bit of a control problem at the top. It's another top lift. He must be very, very happy with that.
Marvellous effort by the Turk again. He didn't have things all his own way in the snatch. But that weight has surely given him the silver medal.
Technically very fast, and he must be on his absolute maximum here, as one of his teammates signaled to him when he came off the platform. I think they said you've got the very, very best out of yourself here.
Left to follow will be Chen.
So third attempt for Kim Hakbong, 182.5. And he needs this to wrest back that third place ahead of Bem of Germany. They'll be equal, but Kim Hakbong has a lighter body weight.
This is just 2.5 kilograms more than his second attempt, but sometimes in lifting it's hard enough to repeat what you've just done, let alone do that little bit more. And of course there's the pressure attached to this lift.
He missed his first clean and jerk at 180. This is 2.5 kilograms heavier. This is for a possible bronze. Gallantry from the Korean.
Good lift by a majority decision.
The judges are happy. Two white lights is enough. So it's back on Andreas Bem now from Germany to surpass this man.
Well, he really deserved this lift. He has a lot of trouble getting out of it. And his previous attempt on 180 gave him a lot of trouble in the jerk part. So I really didn't think he'd get this one here. He took plenty of time and just fights it all the way. Terrific.
A junior world record lift. So Andreas Bem is going up another 2.5 kilograms to 185, his third and final attempt. This is for the bronze medal position. He has to overtake Kim Hakbong of Korea. Batmaz of Turkey has already clinched the silver.
185 kilograms on the bar, 407 pounds in the old system. And he himself weighs less than 70 kilograms, or 11 stone. Good strong clean. He's normally strong in the jerk. And there it is.
An Olympic bronze at Barcelona, and now a world championship bronze here in Melbourne for Andreas Bem of Germany. A pressure lift. And he was equal to the task.
He's very, very happy with that lift. At 31 years of age, he's just beaten out the junior.
Bulgaria.
Kim Hak Bong for the bronze medal.
But here's the man who's already clinched the gold medal. A clean sweep, in fact. Yotov of Bulgaria. His first attempt successful at 182.5. His second here at 187.5. Bulgarian coaches. He's gone up 5 kilograms from his first lift. If successful here, it will equal the world record total.
He took his time before he got to the bar, but once he got there, he was all action. And it's another easy lift. Terrific.
The all-action man, Yotov.
Good lift for Yotov.
Equaling the world record total. And that probably indicates that he may not lift his final attempt. 187.5 to give him a commanding situation overall.
I think I'd agree with you there, Gordon. The way he reacted to that lift, I don't think he will be taking a third because he's looked all business right through, as we said, a man with a mission. But I just happened to notice that his coach indicated that he will be taking a third. No, his coach thought he'd take, but Yotov had other ideas, so he's not taking a third.
He will not take his third attempt.
Well, what a fantastic athlete. The Bulgarian, 10 kilograms ahead of his nearest rival, Batmaz of Turkey, with Bem of Germany pipping Hak Bong Kim of South Korea for the bronze. And from 5th through to 10th, those lifters all coming through from the B division. So a hat-trick for the Bulgarian men after the earlier wins of Ivanov and Peshelov. The Chinese women have also won 3 of the 4 divisions. In tomorrow night's program, 64 kilos for women and 76 for men, featuring Australia's Ron Laycock. Until then, Gordon Bray for ABC Sport.